Afternoon, Carlos.
Afternoon.
Can we start, please, with transfers today? And we don't have to ask you about them anymore, but you can tell us about the players that you've got in the building. Jamal Blackman, let's start with him. Let's go in the order they came in. Tell us why you feel he's someone who can add something to your side.
No, first of all, because Ryan Schofield had the injury. He's going to have a surgery the next week. So his recovery is going to take more time than we expected. Then it's clear that as soon as you have one injury, you have one need. And for me, Blackman is one player that take the cover one need that we have. Because you can, of course, we have as a third keeper, Nick. Until that time, the idea or the plan of the team was to have Schofield as a second keeper and Nick as a third choice. Now with the losing of the second keeper, that was Schofield, we understand that it's better for Nick to his developer to make him the loan in a League 2, that is what exactly we did, and bring someone to cover Schofield because he cannot be available during the season. So we understand that Jamal Blackman is one keeper with a lot of experience in the British football, in Championship, because he was in Sheffield United after he was one part in Leeds without playing many games with the first team, but play more with the 23s. Unfortunately, he was having an injury when I was coaching 123 game, and he had an injury. But after he was recovering well and he was playing in Rotterdam, then after he was out of the country too, playing until 2 months ago, he was playing in America. And now he's with us, so I think he's one player that covered this position with a lot of guarantees because he has experience. I think that he's a very good goalkeeper. Next one.
What about Tino then? What about Tino coming in from Chelsea? Tell us a little bit about what he will add to this side. And is he ready to go right now?
No. The situation with Angelini is that he is in the last part of his recovery from the injury. He was playing in Moscow, in Lokomotiv Moscow, I think, and he had one injury, I think it was in October or November, around this time. Then, now he's fishing because he had one fracture in the bones of the feet, and he is now in the last part of the recovery of this injury. He will be working with the Chelsea medical staff until more or less the middle of this month, of this February. In that moment, he will come here to make the last part of his recovery with us and to start to integrate with the team. If I talk about him as a player, he is one very talented player. He can play as a winger. He can play as a number 10 that for me, I would consider as a main position. He can play as a 7, so he can give you the 3 possibilities, the 3 options in front of the attack. And I think he's one player with a lot of talent that can be that he can have high contribution to the squad. But it's true that first of all, we need to make him ready to training with the group. And we expect to be with our medical staff in around 2 weeks, start to work with the medical staff and start to know the facilities here, start to know the teammates and start to integrate with the team. Fortunately, we are in the last part of his recovery that will take around 2 weeks with Chelsea after to integrate with us.
And then he could be somebody then for that busy period, Easter time, I'm sort of thinking, and towards the back end of the season when you're going to need as many bodies as possible, aren't you, as well? So that'll be like a new signing, maybe a month on from the window closing.
Yes, exactly. I think it's a player that the faster we make him fit or the faster that he can have a recovery, the better to add one member more to the squad. Not about the period that you told me, because for me the busy period is in the Championship. You never know when arrive the busy period. Now we are going to play, for example, 1 month in February. This is one of the more busy period of the football, but for me it's one very, very, for me, interesting player with a very good work for me from the club to bring someone with his potential, because he can help us, but now we need to be a little bit patient with him because he's finishing his recovery.
And the one that I think got most fans excited was the return of Carroll Eiting as well. Did it get you as excited when you realised you could bring him back into the building?
I think I understand the bring of Carroll Eiting as another need that we have. For me, from Willows, Vallejo, another long-term injury. For me, we needed to have in the middle of the pitch someone that can give the opportunity, can help the team to have the ball from the back. And for me, this is really one of the reasons why Eiting is here with us, because first of all, he was working with us before and he was showing a desire to come back to Huddersfield. This is something that is important, first of all. And we know that the time that we were working with him, he was one player that he had a high contribution from to this club the last year in the Championship. In the period that he was fit, in the first part of the season when he was fit, he for me had a very high contribution to the dynamic, to the positive result, the positive dynamic of the team in that period of time. As soon as you bring someone that is not from the British, is not a British player, you know that you're going to need a little bit of time of adaptation. But for me, with 18, is total opposite, because 18 is one player that knows perfectly the players that we have here. He knows how we work, he knows the staff, he knows the everything that we have here in Huddersfield. So he reduced a lot the time. For me, is one sign that he's able to be, tomorrow is going to be with the team. So it means that if everything goes well, he will be with the team. And it means that it's an immediate improvement to the squad. And for me, in that moment of that market, this is one of the things that we need to be thinking too. As soon as someone is not from this football, he's going to need a little bit of time. But even he's a Netherlands player, his pass, especially in UK, his pass here with us in our club, made that this period of adaptation is going to be, there is not going to be. He's going to be an immediate player for the squad. That this is something that for me in this market is very important too.
Yeah, that is very rare as well, actually, isn't it? He's just spoken to us an hour or so ago, and he said it was about the people at Huddersfield Town. That's why he wanted to come back. He wanted to come back to work with all the people he's previously worked with, which must be really nice for you to hear as well, you and your coaching staff and all the staff at the football club.
I think he was talking more about the teammates than for the staff, I think.
You think so?
Not sure.
He had praise for everybody. He had praise for the kit men, the physios, the staff, the players, which just shows what you have at the club at the moment, doesn't it? That unity.
I think it's difficult, in my opinion, it's difficult to be a Huddersfield player and don't enjoy or don't appreciate the environment that is created here. I don't talk as a coach, I don't talk about my methods. No, I am talking about club. About this club. This club is very familiar, it's very close. It's like one club that is going to give you all the support that you need to have as a player to have success. So for me, it's important. This is what I understand that Eddie was telling, that he feeling one club where the relations are close, where we go everyone with the same mentality or the same targets. And this is just that he can have a special relation with the player, with the people here in this club, because it's very humble people and very easy to create this connection.
So as a whole then, and as a final comment on the January window, I suppose, how pleased are you with the work that the club has managed to do in that window? Both players coming in and youngsters being able to go out on loan as well to get some experience and the likes. How pleased are you with the job that Lee Bromby and his team have managed to do with your squad in the January window?
I think as a club, I only can see that we have grown. First of all, because like you say, now if we start to see the players on loan, we can make one team even more, starting from the keeper, central backs, with Ben Jackson now, with the keeper, Nick, going to lead to one club in League 2 yesterday, is one player alone. Chris Lowe with the new step to League 1 to be alone with Eamon Green. This is the two players that are now in League 1, one in Plymouth, another one in Rotterdam. So we have two players now in League 1. Matty Daly now have changed the club in League 2, now is in Bradford, so he's another player in League 2. We have two players that are playing now, like Austerfield and Brahima, that both are playing in League 2, too, in Harrogate, so it's another improvement for me for the club. And I don't know if I am missing. Yes, Phillips now have changed the club too in League 2, and that's why for me we start to see that our young players, we are developing them in the high level. So for me as a club, it's an improvement, an improvement as a club, because it's not only that we have the B team here now in the first team, we find one gap that we are covering with the loan. So it's a fantastic for me growing. In terms of the first team, we have for me two needs, the because the injuries, no, the keeper that we have covered for me in a very good way. That's why for me the work of the scouting area that is leading by Lee Bromby has been excellent, because for me the replacement of the keeper has been excellent. The replacement for me of Vallejo has been excellent, with one player that was, I understand that was not easy to take, but I think the connection that Lee Bromby is creating with every player that he's working is too high and makes that the player can have the desire to come back. And after the act of injury, for me, is demands me to be patient in terms of the because you always are excited to work with players with level of talent, but you need to be patient too. But this one player that can help, I think, a lot the squad too.
So team news-wise, then that brings me on to, how are you looking ahead of the game with Derby County? Injuries-wise, firstly, how's Pipa? Can I ask what his situation is?
Pipa has made the training today, so he will be available for the, he can be available for the game. Then after, Cole will continue with the long-term recovery that we were talking about before to that game. And maybe the new, the more new situation that 18 is going to be involved with the squad too. So he will be like the new face, and we are going to recover the possibility to have Pipa with the team too.
Okay, so you've got good options there now, haven't you? What do you make to Derby County as the team you're coming up against? They've had an unbelievable season, haven't they? A ridiculous season.
Yes, I think the work that they are doing, that Derby County, all the players and the staff with Rooney, for me has been excellent, because they are facing the difficulty that they have with the points deduction, with the highest level of respect to the, every football people, and with the making what they have to do, but what is not easy to do is face the difficulty making the best football that you can to keep fighting for the target that they have. And for me, they are doing a fantastic season, that if you don't take the point deduction, the situation in the table will be totally different. In like, this is what this team is able to do, is the point that they have. So it's clear that in the adversity, they are doing a one job that I like to recognize, because is in a difficult situation, it's not easy to do.
Are you surprised at all at the job Wayne Rooney is doing? Young coach, very difficult situation for him to be involved in his first managerial position. It could be too much for some people, couldn't it?
No, I think sometimes I watching that they have experience, that, and it's true that for me there is one club that they are using very well the resources that they have, because for me the new players that they are in the club now, especially the new young players that they have, for me they are making a good job. And if you analyze the squad, it's one squad that they have made. For me, I understand that it's a squad with resources, starting from the keeper, with the central backs. They have one of the central backs, Stillman, that was with us in the last 3 years in this club. So, 2 years, around 2 years, yes, in the club. And after, they have a very good mix of players with experience, like can be, for example, Lawrence. Lawrence is one player that, if I don't have a bad memory, he was even in the playoff that they were playing against us with Leeds. I remember when I was in Leeds, he was making this playoff. So for me, they have find a good balance between the new players that they have in the club, like can be Beard or can be the midfielder Thompson, or some of the players that they have, with the player with more experience and more experience, especially this is in the Championship.
Good stuff. Thank you, Carlos. All the best tomorrow night.
Thank you so much.
Thanks, Johnny. Stephen, we'll come to you, please.
Hey, Carlos. I mean, on the transfer window, you said last week that keeping players was, to you, as important as adding players. So you must be delighted that you've kept the squad together.
I think sometimes, like I told you, sometimes when we talk about the market, there is another possibility is to lose some of the players that for you understand that they are being important. But it's a positive news, first of all, that we keep all our full squad, that we find, for me, the right replacements for the player that we were missing by the injuries. And one, we add even 1 point more of one player that as soon as he be fit, I think is one player with a lot of potential to have a high level of contribution.
Yeah, it's been two very positive windows. As you say, Lee Bromby and his team have done a fantastic job. Do you feel that they have shown a level of ambition in this window with these signings?
I never have doubt that when arrived to the club one player, is because the work that Lee Bromby and all his people, they are doing amazing, because I know the list of the players that they were managing, I know how many guests they are watching, I know the proposal that they do. And for me, it's difficult that you don't like one of the players they propose to bring to the club. And the reason in the back, any player for me are reasons that I share with them. In all the players that they can show me and they can propose me, it's difficult to don't be agree that the player wouldn't be a high contribution or a positive contribution to the club. So always for me, it's fantastic to be working with people in the one that you believe, because they show, not in the one that you believe, in the people that have proof, but even before I was arrived here, that they can make an excellent job.
And for tomorrow night, do you have any new injuries at all, or any absentees?
No, what I say, Pipa was working today with the group, so he's going to be available for tomorrow. Gary Layton was working today too with the group, so he will be available too for the game tomorrow. And from the and like I say, only Cole Will, in terms of the player that can be involved in the next games, only Cole Will. Instead, we need to be patient with him to have the to have him to come back to the with the group.
Okay, where do you see Carolighting fitting in to your squad? You've got a lot of good options in central midfield now.
Yes, now for me it's clear. I understand that Aiden is one midfielder player. I think he can. He has the main position of him is playing as a number eight, because as a number eight is one player that can go to the box, go close to the opponent box to give the last pass in the action. Something that he was showing that he can do very well. He, for me, is a specialist to make these type of actions. He's someone that even can arrive to the opponent box and finish the action, because he has scored goal with us, even heading the ball. And he's one player that he can help a lot for me in the playing out too, because he's one number eight who can drop as a double number six position to help you to have the ball and link from the ball from the defenders to the attacking players. So that's why I understand that was a very good replacement, because he can play not only as a number six or not only as a number eight. He's one player that can have a little bit of versatility. One player who can play more middle right and middle left. He doesn't feel uncomfortable in any of the both sides, and he can play as a number eight that arrived to the box, was a number eight that drew more to help the team in the first part of the attack part. So I understand that. That's why I understand that he's a very good midfielder.
Yeah, I feel like specifically he can help you with what we talked about after Stoke, the difficulty playing out from the edge of your own box. I seem to recall he was really good at getting counter-attacks going last time he was here.
I think at the end, a good player is one player that is able to manage the different moments of the games in attack, the different moments of the games, of course, are the personal attack and the counter-attack. And after, one good midfielder is able to defend too. I think the way that we are defending this year, I think can help Aiden too, to be another help in defense. And I hope that he can show all the skills that he has, and we will be focused to make that Aiden is showing again all the skills that he has, because we know that he's a player that can help a lot of the team to have the ball and to create attacks.
And on Andrin, I know you say you hope to have him at the club in a couple of weeks. When do you expect he'll be available to play for the club, or is that a bit up in the air at the moment?
I think it's difficult to tell you, because with the problem in his bone, everything is going to depend about how he progresses. We know that from the scan that he had the previous weekend, his injury have improved a lot. That's why we can say that he's in the last part of his recovery. We decide him to keep working with the Chelsea staff, medical staff, because they were managing the injury until one point where he can start to work his conditions, so his physical conditions to the football situations. At that point, he will come with us to start to know the teammates, start to know the facilities, start to be working in some of the drills with the group. So I cannot give you one time, because it's impossible for me, because everything is going to depend about how he progresses with the work. I can tell you that he's in the last part of his recovery. In this last part, we understand that the best thing is to continue working with the Chelsea medical staff, because we're there until they finish this step. As soon as he moves to the step where he can start to make more specific football work, is the step that he will start to integrate with us in the group. And I think that this will happen around in the middle of this February. That's why we have more or less the idea to have around 2 weeks he wouldn't be with us.
Great. I think that's all from me. Thanks, Carlos. Good luck tomorrow.
Thank you, Steve. Alfie, we'll come to you.
Hi, Carlos. How are you doing?
Good, thank you so much.
Good stuff. After Friday, you spoke about how your side struggled to keep their intensity in the second half a little bit. With a game midweek and then another one to come at the weekend, how much does that play on your mind with regards to selection for Derby, or will more changes likely to come in the Cup?
I think in some games you have, it's clear that when you don't have the ball and you want to recover the ball, you need intensity to be, the only way to recover the ball is to be aggressive, and to be aggressive need intensity. It's clear that as soon as you don't have the level of intensity will be challenged to recover balls against some teams. But it's true that to can be intense without the ball, it's important to have the ball, recover when you have the ball, and move the game to one situations where recover the ball doesn't be a high challenge. When recover the ball, you can find with less level of effort because it's more easy. For me, sometimes many things that happen in the football depend about what you do when you have the ball. For me, the other day in the first half, we were managing very good disbalance between attack and defense, with a good moment in attack that allow us to have chances, or if we didn't create the chance, to lose the ball in offensive half. In football, when you lose the ball in offensive half, is the best moment that you have to try to make a recovery of the ball, because if you were making the opponent team defending, they are prepared to defend, they are not prepared to attack. As soon as you lose the ball in your pitch, the opponent team is the one that is prepared to attack and you have to be prepared to defend. Then to be aggressive is more challenge. So that's why I think it's important to use the intensity in the moments that we can be intense to recover the ball. But the most important thing for me, how I see football, is to be able to use the ball in a good conditions that allow us to dominate the games and allow us to lose the ball in easy conditions that demand less effort to recover the ball.
Yeah, and just the final one from me. I think it was Steve that pointed out on Friday night how well Ollie Turton played against Stoke with Pippa coming back. Can you just tell me a little bit about what differences and what similarities they have at right back?
I think, first of all, for me, I cannot be more pleased, as I am so pleased as a coach to have the two right backs that I have. And I am so pleased as a coach to have the two left backs in the left that we have with Toffolo, Ruffles, Pipa and Turton. As a coach, I think it's difficult for me to be working with better fullbacks. And for me, all of them are players that for me can make difference in his position in the championship. So I understand that all these four players are different, but all these four players have a very good balance between give you possibilities in attack without have the consequence to don't defense well. And for me, all of them have this balance. It's true that for me, Pipa is one player that is very capable with the ball and someone that needs to defend with more concentration or more focus in defense. And maybe Turton, you can find one player that is very comfortable in defense because he has developed a lot of skills, but is a player with offensive resources too. I remember that the game that we won against Blackburn, I hope, I changed Sorba Thomas at that moment. We put Turton and he was doing the cross or he was assisting Danny Ward. So he's a player that he can give you a lot of, he can cover all the long of the pitch, Turton. And Pipa is exactly the same. Maybe Pipa can surprise the opponent more driving the ball and Turton can surprise in attack more with the pass and the movement because he's more fast player. And both players are very good players from in defense. Pipa is true that if you need to evaluate his defensive skills in offensive skills, maybe he's someone that calls attention more by the offensive skills, even if he has all the skills that one fullback needs to have as a defender. And maybe it's just the with Turton, he can call more attention about the defensive work that he can do, even if he's someone that can make difference, because it's not only the assist that I told you in the big chance that we have, for example, against Swansea, the big save of Benzema in the finishing of O'Brien. The action starts with one double pass between Turton and Sinani, and Turton after pass to Danny Ward, Danny Power pass to Sorba, Sorba to O'Brien. So for me, I find that all the four fullbacks that we have made me feel that anyone that we decide in the first 11 because how we see the opponent or how we understand that they are physical conditions, we are going to make the right thing because for me, all of the players are, for me, amazing fullbacks to play in this level.
Brilliant. Thank you. Best of luck tomorrow.
You're welcome.
Cheers, Alfie. Saif, I'm assuming you're okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. Are you okay, Carlos?
Right. Thanks, guys. We'll see you all tomorrow then.